We are set for some fun today in the Cafe studio. Austin's Black Joe Lewis is back with a new album with the Honey Bears. Electric Slave, his last album, came out in 2013, and it was a little bit different sounding, a little more bluesy, a little bit more rocky, but we're kind of splitting hairs when you come to the blues, funk, soul, rock sound of this band. This new one is just great. Some tough rhythm lines on here all up front and some really good writing. And please welcome back to the Cafe, Black Joe Lewis and the Honey Bears. That is PTP, one you've already heard on the World Cafe from Black Joe Lewis and the Honey Bears. You have not heard it like that. That is live. And Joe, good to see you, first of all.
You too.
Thanks for being here. I got to ask, PTP.
Well, I had a friend that was dating a stripper, and she was dressing him and telling him where to be and stuff. And he would drive her around to go on dates with other men for money.
Wow.
And he would like be take care of our kids stuff, and I'm like, man, what's, you know, you're getting ran here. And he's like, I can't stop, it's too good, you know. So
she had the power.
Yes,
but of specific kind. I think I get that.
Yeah.
You know, you've come by a few times. You started making music about a decade ago, and you're from Austin. And man, I suspect that there have been some serious changes since 2007 in Austin. How are you reacting to that? Are there places that you miss that aren't there and stuff like that?
You know, people, I think it's like more like people like call the code department on you for like having long grass, stuff like that, whereas it wasn't like that before.
Right.
That kind of attitude overall. You know, there's a lot of like there's like a whole new downtown community that's kind of interfering with the music scene now. And, you know, whereas like, I feel like Austin built this name off of being a music city, but now they're kind of catering to those people, I guess, you know. So it's still cool overall, though. You know, there's still a lot of good bands and stuff. There's all every night there's something to go do and see. So,
well, it is in Texas, and Texas is
a
different kind of place, right?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
For sure. Your first album with the Honey Bears was really raw, and I'm going to use the word naive. That was kind of charming to me. But as an artist, do you look back and go, what was I doing? Or
you're just like, just better now, you know, or I am. And then, you're just like, man, I wish I could do what I do now and like did it back then.
Right. Well, when you came by with Electric Slave, you were talking a lot about getting serious and about your writing and kind of doing what you wanted to do. And how does Backlash, the title, I'm trying to figure out how it relates to that, or what is that?
Oh, I guess like if you're just doing your own thing and just like repercussions from actions, you know?
Yeah. So, yeah. You know, you're not changing kind of your attitude about doing things, though.
No. Yeah. But maybe I got in a backlash for not changing.
Oh.
I don't know.
You think so? You think so?
Yeah.
That's interesting. Everybody gets credit in writing. How does that work?
You mean like as far as like in the band?
Yeah, I noticed that.
We just sit down and talk about it. You know, I guess it's more like we'll just think about who did what and whoever did the most on it, you know. We split it up like that, you know.
So. Do you come in with tunes or how
do... sometimes a lot of them a lot of stuff will be jams, you know, something that'll come up and we'll record it or whatever and it'll be like, we'll see if we can make some out of that or sometimes I'll have an idea and I'll bring it in, you know, so
right. It's
a little bit of everything.
Well, I'm feeling more of, I mean, you've always had guitars out front with the horns, but I'm loving the rhythm parts on this record. And were you listening to anything that might have influenced those? You're going to do this one called Sexual Attention, man. I hear this is a great one.
Oh, yeah, you know, I like Nile Rodgers a lot, you know what I'm saying? So, like, you know, and just... disco, more like the funk stuff, just not as much strings or whatever, but you know,
he's an amazing rhythm player,
so yeah, he is.
There you go,
definitely.
So, we'll give him inspiration for this a little bit. This is Sexual Tension. Sexual Tension, live in the studio with Black Joe Lewis and the Honey Bears. And since I was talking about the rhythm guitars, two great ones on that. Joe, go around the room. Who's playing today?
Oh, you got Mike Brinley on the guitar, Bill Stevenson on the bass, Sam Powell on the keys, Jason Fry on the tenor sax, Joe Woolard on the baritone sax, and Doug Levitin on the drums.
Two saxophones this time around. You've had a trumpet before, right?
Yeah, we did. He quit, but people come and go.
Are you a hard taskmaster? Or?
I don't think so. Yeah. You might not want
to
ask.
You seem
him.
Completely laid back to me, so what do I know? We talked about Nile Rodgers, but any other musical inspiration on this record, things you were listening to?
I'm a big Bruce fan. I don't think a lot of people know that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, I don't know if that really crept into too much of this album, though. Maybe there's a few songs, maybe. But
do you have a favorite Bruce album?
Oh man, I think I like The River a lot.
Yeah.
The second one is it? The Innocent.
Wild the Innocent.
Yeah.
In the East Street Shuffle. That's a good one.
Yeah.
That's a real far ranging one too. You've talked about Lightnin' Hopkins as being an influence, and I can certainly see a bunch of stuff, the rawness of Lightnin' and stuff that might be there. But you also mentioned in the same breath Iggy Pop. And talk a little bit about Iggy's influence.
Man, I started listening to Iggy Pop when I was like probably 18 or 17 or something. I had a job at this factory and I was wearing a Sublime shirt. And there's this dude with like the spiked up hair, you know, like totally from the 80s. And I was like, yeah, man, you like punk rock? I like punk rock. He's like, yeah, but I don't like that band. That band sucks. And I was like, okay, who I listen to? And he was like this and this, you know, like, and then I kind of got into a lot of stuff off that guy. And I just always loved Iggy Pop, man. I don't know, just the way it sounds.
Do you remember what albums he gave you?
Like, I had Raw Power.
Oh, yeah.
And I had, he turned me on to the Dead Boys. And the Damned, you know, and I kind of took it from there. But
well, that, you know, people don't always talk about the punk rock influence of what you do, but there's a lot of punk in there.
Yeah,
I would think definitely. What do you guys want to do next?
I think we're doing "Freaking Out."
All right,
a song called "Freaking Out."
Myself can't make a mess. I know I'm a dog, but I try to do my best. Baby, if you was my teacher, I'd pass all my tests. And I wanna be your pet, sitting every day under your desk. I'm tripping out down the stairs. I think I broke my neck trying to look at you. Chill, so straight box. Call me when you move, and I'll put things in your box. Yeah, something I always do is play your fool. I play it for you. And you know it's free of charge. Just a dog barking in your yard. I'm tripping out down the stairs. I think I broke my neck trying to look at you. I'm freaking out. For me, then we take the liberty to stick my head in, have a peek. You started to scream, oh, what's wrong? Thought you'd be happy to see me. I thought I was your pet.
Freaking Out, that is Black Joe Lewis and the Honey Bears live in our studio. And there's even a dream in the middle of that one, right?
I guess it's somebody else's nightmare.
Okay. You have a song in here called Nature's Natural. And I was wondering if you could kind of tell a little bit about what this thing's about.
You know, it's, I was watching, I wrote the song whenever the Ferguson thing went on.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's kind of like after the Trayvon thing and then all this stuff started happening. It kind of just made me mad. I was like, this is just like the new norm. And then, you know, and I just see, you know, all the footage of black people tearing up their own neighborhoods and stuff. I'm like, go tear up the other guy's neighborhood, not yours. And then I start thinking about, like, black-on-black crime. And then, like, you know, the whole thing, like, you know, the community's got to learn how to respect itself before the outsiders are going to respect it, you know. So it's just, like, all that came together.
Yeah, are there a lot of black people living in Austin?
No.
Yeah. Is that a hassle?
It's kind of lame. It used to be more. I feel like, you know, like one of the things that's changed with the city growing is the diversity has gone out the window, you know? You still got a lot of Latinos. Yeah, it's just not a lot of that going on there.
Well, I'm glad you wrote this one. Why don't you do it? It's called Nature's Natural.
There's a fire burning in the ghetto, and from a ghost long dead, its flames are fed by the winds of a terrible crown. They make this a bitch down the hands of my. They can't hear over the sound of their empty pockets. Their secrets left to be told. In the evidence of their murder just the other day, these are things that they choose to withhold. Thank you.
That's called Nature's Natural, and that's another one of the new ones from the fine new Black Joe Lewis and Honey Bears album called Backlash. Hey, thank you for coming by.
Thanks. Appreciate you having us.
It's always great to have the band by. We shall be back in a moment here on the World Cafe.